Hello students, so in this video we will be studying about what are the general obligations and responsibilities of merchant banking. Means here general obligations and responsibilities means what are the overall tasks and duties you should be performed by the merchant banker. Means what are the tasks and duties you should be followed. Okay, these are the various points which includes in this general obligations and responsibilities of merchant banking. So first one is code of conduct. Okay, code of conduct means you should have some certain rules and regulations. As I explained in the previous video, code of conduct means here what happens, here every merchant banker shall abide by the code of conduct. Means you should have certain code of conduct, like he should means here merchant banker should make all efforts like to protect the interest of their investors. Also like a merchant banker should maintain high standard of integrity. Means he should be honest, and he should be respect, and should be fairness, means equal. He should have some fairness in the conduct of its business. Also he should be prompt, he should be ethics, and also he should behave in a professional manner. Okay, and he should provide adequate disclosures made to the investors in timely manner. Okay, these are the as well as he should not discriminate among its clients. So these are the various code of conduct he should follow. So second point is maintenance of books of account, records and documents. Means he should maintain some books of account, records and documents. Like he should maintain a copy of balance sheet. Okay, he should maintain a copy of balance sheet as the end of the each accounting period, as well as he should maintain a copy of P&L account, that is profit and loss account, as well as he should maintain a copy of auditor's report. Means what are the auditor's report have been made, what are the corrections on auditors have been made. He should maintain that auditor's report. And every merchant banker shall, after the each of the ending accounting period, means they should furnish all these board copies of the balance sheet, P&L account, such other documents for any presiding 5 years when it is required. Means they should maintain of minimum 5 years of this account whenever required. Means he should maintain minimum 5 years of balance sheet of account, P&L account, and other documents whenever it is required. Okay, whenever it is required. And next third point is submission of half yearly results. Means submission of half yearly results means semi annually result he should maintain. Means here every merchant banker shall furnish to the board, means provide to the board of half yearly unaudit financial results. Okay, whenever it's required by the board with a view to monitor the capital adequacy of the merchant banker. Means every merchant banker should furnish half yearly unaudit financial results. Unaudit financial results means which is not still approved by the external auditor. Means in half yearly results where internal audit will maintain all the records. Means here unaudit financial results means which is not still approved by the external, means which is prepared only by the internal auditor, means still which is not approved by the external audit, for that we call as unaudit financial statements. This unaudit financial statement should be given to the board to monitor the view of capital adequacy of merchant banker, and he should maintenance of books of accounts, records and other documents in half yearly results. Understood? Submission of half yearly results. Okay, next comes preserving of books of account. Preserving of books of account means protecting the books of account. Preserving means protecting, or we call as maintaining the books of account. So preserving of books of account means where the other records and documents should maintain under regulations for minimum period of 5 years. Preserving books of account means where the balance sheet, profit and loss account, auditor's reports, where for minimum 5 years in merchant banker, this all record should be kept for how much? Minimum 5 years. Minimum 5 years. Okay, preserving of books of account means like other documents, records, we have like balance sheet, P&L account, auditor's report, where we should preserve for minimum 5 years. Okay, next comes report on steps taken on auditor reports. With auditor's reports, he checks all the documents and records, means where whatever he have given some steps to measure, where the merchant banker should take the steps, means every merchant banker shall, means he should within 2 months from the dates of auditor reports, he should take some steps to rectify the defenses made out in the auditor's report. Means suppose if auditor has given some report, within 2 months of the report he should take some immediate actions in the business, like he will tell to appoint some lead managers, that he should take some he should take serious about the auditor's report. Next comes appointment of lead managers. Here what happens, all issues should be managed by at least one merchant banker, means lead merchant banker. Means here what happens, we should appoint some lead managers. Why we should appoint this? Means all issues should be managed, means what are the issues happen should be managed by at least one lead merchant banker, means functioning as a lead manager, means every lead banker he will enter into an agreement with such body corporate, like setting to out some mutual rights like liabilities as well as obligations relating to such in a particular, to disclose like some allotment of, to do something about refund, allotment of refund. So next, once we have appointed the lead managers, means usually the lead managers appointed to see the functioning of the business, means how the business is happening. This lead manager will enter into an agreement which such to body corporate to set up some mutual rights, means what are the rights or profits should be shared, to share some liabilities and obligations. Once we are appointed the lead managers, there will be some responsibilities of lead managers. Means what are the responsibilities of lead manager will be same. Here lead managers relating to the issue, like specify his responsibilities, is to furnish to the board mainly to those disclosures, means what allotment should be made and what refund are clearly defined, whether refund are clearly defined or not, what are the allocated and determined. If there are more than one lead merchant banker to the issue, the responsibilities of each such of lead merchant banker shall clearly be, statements specify such responsibilities shall be furnished. As well as a lead merchant banker should not associate with merchant banker without registrations. Means here lead merchant banker should not enter into merchant banker without registrations. Okay, understood? Responsibilities means you should not enter to associate the merchant banker without registration. Next comes a lead merchant banker not to associate with merchant banker without registration. Means a lead merchant banker should not be associate with any issue if a merchant banker is not holding a certificate associate with the issue. Means a lead man lead merchant banker should not enter without any registration. Registration is compulsory. Next comes 9 point, acquisition of shares prohibited. Means here no merchant banker or any of its directors, means no merchant banker or any of its directors like partners or managers or principal officers shall either on their respective accounts or through their associates or their relatives into any transaction in securities of this body's corporate specific on the basis of unpublished price or sensitive informations obtained by them during the course of any professional assignment, either from their clients or either from their issues. Next comes submission of, next point is submission of due diligence certificate. Here the lead merchant banker, suppose who is responsible for the verification of the contents of the prospectus or the letter of the other in respect of an issue and the reasonableness of the views accepted, they shall submit to the board at least 2 weeks prior to opening of the issue to the subscriptions. A due diligence certificate will be in form of C. Next comes information to the board. Here every merchant banker, what they should do, they shall submit the board complete particular informations of any transactions or the acquisitions of securities of any body corporate whose issue is being managed by the merchant banker within 15 days, within 15 days from the date of entering in such transactions. Next comes disclosures to the board. Here a merchant banker compulsory shall disclose the board as when it is required the following like information, namely like his responsibilities with regard to the management of issues or there is any change in the informations informations or particular previously furnished which have been bearing on certificate grant to it or the names of the body corporates whose issues he has been managed or he has been associate with. Next come here also the merchant banker shall submit a periodic report in such a manner may be specified the board from time to time. Next, appointment of compliance officer. Means here every merchant banker should appoint a compliance officer. Means who shall be responsible like for monitoring the compliance of the act, like what are the rules and regulations should be there, what are the notifications should be given, what are the guidelines or instruction etc. issued by the board or the central government for the redressal of the investors like grievances. Here the compliance officer shall immediately and independently report to the board or any compliance observed by him or ensure that all the observation made pointed by the board on the draft prospectus or the letter of the offer as in the case be do not to recur. So next comes obligations of merchant banker on inspection by the board. So it shall be the duty of every like director, proprietor, partner, officer and employee of the merchant banker who is being inspected to the produce to the inspecting authority like such books, accounts and other documents in his custody or control and furnish him with the statements like information relating to his activities merchant banker within such a time inspecting authority may require. Here the merchant banker should allow the inspecting authority to have some reasonable access to their premises this premise is occupied by such merchant banker or by the any other person on behalf of, and also extend for examining any books, records, documents and computer data in possession of merchant banker. So this was about the general obligations of merchant banking.